Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see how to log in using Firebase Authentication. In last tutorial, we have created an user using Firebase. In this video, we'll see how to log in with the user credential. In the login page, I have a button called Login. On click of the button, we need to do the login using the credentials given by the user. So, setting OnClick Listener for the button. Inside, we need to validate the username and password. So, creating a function called doLogin inside our login activity. I'm copying the validation from signup activity and pasting it here. Then, importing the views from activity main instead of activity signup. If all the validation is OK, then we need to do login. To do login, go to Firebase Authentication page. Here, we already did the user creation. Scroll down and you will see the method for user sign-in. To do sign-in, we need to use sign-in with email and password method. So, I'm copying the code and pasting it in our project. Here also, we need to pass email as TV username text. And for password, we need to pass TV password text. If user sign in is success, then we will get is successful as true inside calling update UI. If the login is failed, then showing the toast as login failed, also calling update UI method. When user sign in is success, then I want to go to next page. So I'm creating a new activity called dashboard activity. Inside update UI function, checking whether the current user is null or not. If the current user is not null, then login is successful. In this case, we want to go to next activity. So, launching dashboard activity using an intent. If login is failed, then the current user will come as null. In this case, I am showing the toast. This update UI method is accessed only in this class, so I am making this as private function. Now we'll launch the application. Let's log in with our credentials. This time I'm giving the wrong password. You can see we are getting the toast as login failed. Let's try with the correct password. This time it's going to dashboard activity. When I press the back button, the app is getting closed. Because we are calling finish after launching dashboard activity. Let's open the app again. You can see it's directly going to dashboard activity. Because in onStart, we are checking the user from auth object. We haven't logged out, so we are getting valid user here. That's why we are going to dashboard activity. Now we'll see how to verify user email address. Also, blocking the non-verified user from access. In authentication, under Android, we need to select Manage User. Here, we need to look for user verification. When user is signing up, we need to send an email verification to the user. So, I'm opening signup activity. When user signup is successful, then we need to send the verification mail. To send that, we need user object. So, I'm getting the user object from auth object. Then, calling send email verification method using the user object. Once the email is sent, we will get the callback. So, I'm launching the login activity here. Now, we'll see how to block the user whose email ID is not verified. To do that, inside update UI, I'm checking is email verified flag. If it is true, then the user email is already verified. So, I'm going to dashboard activity. If it is false, then showing the toast as, please verify your email address. Before doing sign up, I'm removing the user from Firebase. Now we'll launch the application. Let's click on Don't have account. Registering with the same email address and password. You can see after creating the user, it's going to login activity. Let's login with our credential. You can see we are getting the toast as please verify your email address. To verify the email address, I'm opening the mail. You can see we got the mail from Firebase. Click on the link which you got to verify your email address. After verification, you can login with your account. You can see this time it allowed us to dashboard activity. Like this, we can use Firebase to allow only verified users to access our application. That's all for this video, guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you want to support me, you can do that by becoming a patron at patreon.com/codeandroid. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.